Welcome to the Movies Feature tutorial. In this video, we're going to be covering how to stream a movie live to your guests during your web conference. So the first thing we're going to do is go up and click on Movies and go over the page just a little bit. The first thing you'll see at the top is the address bar. Here you will put in the link or the URL of the movie you would like to stream to your guests. Now you can click on Show Movie or just hit Enter after you're done typing it in, or you can copy and paste. You also have a history. You can delete that history here, or you can access the history by clicking on the drop-down arrow. See that we do have some sample files available to us, just so you can see what it looks like. But before we click on one of those, I'm going to go over the other things on the page. At the top of the window, we have a little guide to prepare your videos for streaming. So the first thing you want to do is, if you don't have an encoder already, you'll need to download an encoder. One we have here is called the Riva encoder, and it's downloaded for free. And this will change any of your MPEG files, QuickTime files, AVI files to the FLV format. And that's the most important part, is your streaming files need to be in FLV format. They cannot be in SWF or in any of the other file formats. It needs to be in FLV. I hope I've made that clear. Now, once you've saved your video in the FLV format, either using the Riva encoder or saving your video directly to the FLV format when you edit it, you'll simply need to find a place to host that video. Now, if you already have a website, you'll be able to upload that video to your website, and it doesn't need to be in a public location where somebody can click on it from your website, but you do need to be able to access it from the web. Once you have that uploaded to the site, you'll need the URL. You'll place that URL into the address bar, and then click on Show Movie, or like I said before, hit the Enter key. Now the URL will look something like this. It will have the HTTP plus the :// then the website address, the folder where the video is located, and then either a subfolder or the video itself goes right after that. And I'm showing you this just so you have an idea of what the address should look like, and also the most important thing, at the very end, you always need to have .flv, or if it's an MP3 audio file, you can have .mp3. Either one of those two file types will play inside this player. So next, we're going to go down to the bottom and look at the tools. You have the play tool, which controls the playing and pausing of the video. Next is the home button. This will take you back to the beginning of the clip. We also have a checkbox here for the host that is applied to all participants. When you have this checkbox checked, everything that you do in this bottom bar will also change on your guest computer. So if you're halfway through the video and you want to pause the video, you simply click on the pause button and it will pause for every participant. If you click on the home button, it will also go back to the beginning for the rest of your participants. And same thing with full screen. Now we also have a volume control bar, but this is only affected on your computer. It does not affect your guest's computer. Your guests will also have this volume bar, so they'll be able to adjust the volume accordingly to their computer. The last thing we have, and what I'll show you while I'm streaming a video, is the scrub bar. So let's go up and click on the video history and select a file. You see that it automatically will start to stream to the computer. The green bar indicates it's loading. Now, you have the scrub bar, and with the scrub bar, I can take this and drag this anywhere inside the clip that's loaded already. And then also remember that wherever you scrub to is also affected on your guest computer. So if there's a certain point in the video that you want to show, you simply scrub to that location, and then everybody else's video will be started at that location. So now I'm going to push it out to full screen so you can see what it looks like in full screen. Now the quality of the video is directly, I'm going to turn down the volume real quick. Now the quality of the video is directly related to the compression you use when you save it and to the server where you have the video hosted. Once you've uploaded the video to your hosting server, depending on that server's internet connection and the number of people in your conference, that will directly relate to how fast the video streams or how fast the loading bar loads. So now I'm going to go ahead and pause the video, bring it back down to normal screen. Now the Riva encoder is only available for the PC, but I'm going to click on download so you can see what it looks like. I'm going to click on run for downloading the installation. It's a 4 meg file, so it'll take a few seconds to download. Once you're done, you'll click on Run. And this will take you up into your setup utility. I'm going to choose English. Click Next. I'm going to agree to the terms of service. I've already read them before, but we suggest that if you don't know the terms of service, that you read them for yourself. Go ahead and click on Next. This will create a new folder. And then choose your options right here. Now, I don't like a lot of desktop icons, so I'm going to go ahead and check off No on that. And I also don't want Riva Encoder to be my default FLV player, so I'm going to turn that off also. I'm going to click on Next, and then I'm going to click on Install. Now the program will begin to install. It's only a 4 meg file, so it should install fairly quickly. Once you're done, click Finish. We're going to have it automatically launch the Riva Encoder for us. Now that it's loaded, you'll see the page here. To output your video, you simply browse and find the video that you would like to play. I'm going to go ahead and select a video that I've already done before, so I'm going to go ahead and select the polling video and then click on Open. You'll see here in the output, this gives me the location where the file will be saved, and then the destination video file, that gives me the name that the file will be saved under. I can change some settings here, like the preset size of the screen. Once again, if you change this, it will affect the size of the video itself. You can also change the frame rate. I film my videos in 24 frames per second, so I'm going to switch that to 24. And then you have your different options down here for padding, cropping. These we don't really need to worry about. They're really not going to affect the quality of our video. So once I'm done with those settings, I want to click on Encode. And we'll let that encode. I don't know how long it's going to take exactly, but I'll join back up with you as soon as it's finished. Once it's done, it'll bring you right back to this screen and it'll say at the bottom, encoding successful. So you simply just go ahead and close out the box and then go to the place where the video was stored. I, for instance, am going to go to my videos and you'll see it says polling FLV right here. So now I'm going to take this file and I'm going to drag that and drop it onto my website. Then I will take the address location, just like this location right here. Obviously, we'll have a URL at the bottom. I will copy and paste that into the address bar of the conference itself. So I'm going to go ahead and close out this box because I'm not going to upload it to a website at this time. But that gives you a good idea of how the FLV encoder works and how quickly it works.